made a very special effort this year to, in fact, make this conference more and more international, and for a couple of reasons. One, because it's also meant to be a gathering of the leaders from around the world, and we recognize that there are folks outside of Canada, and for that matter, outside of North America, who are significant players in the infrastructure and P3 space. And in order to enable a really substantive dialogue to take place, we love having people come from other parts of the world, and we've been very lucky this year. Just in terms of attendance, we have people coming from 30 different countries. That's really, for us, it's a record, and that too reflects, I think, both the relevance of the conference for people, but also recognition that it's a place, a meeting place, for people from around the world who really are all being challenged by many of the same issues. And so it's less about how great are P3s and more about how are we addressing the challenges that weren't there maybe a few years ago but are really impacting the way in which these projects come to market so that we can learn from each other. And that's really valuable. And we're seeing it play out as well on the podium. So many of the sessions are focused on some of the big issues that that the industry is confronting and government for that matter. So the opportunity to bring an international perspective on all of these issues is really what's been motivating our thinking in order to bring that kind of broader perspective to the agenda. I guess one of the clearest recognition of that is the focus we put this year on Indigenous communities and the kinds of issues that they're confronting. First and foremost, they have big infrastructure challenges, large gap, around $30 to $40 billion. So they need to address that. And the other reality is that more and more major projects in Canada are crossing Indigenous lands. So there's an importance that needs to be attached to understanding how to, in fact, get that dynamic more effective. And so we're trying to have both keynote speakers and panelists who come from Indigenous communities because they bring a unique perspective to the discussion. And again, they're confronted by many of the very same issues. So you would have seen that we had Roberta Jameson participate on the skilled trades shortage panel because it's a big issue for Indigenous communities. Our opening keynote speaker was speaking about the challenges being faced by Inuit people in Canada. And he did an outstanding job. You know, he's sensitive, he's articulate, and he laid out an agenda of challenges that we as a council are very focused on because we're working very closely with a number of Indigenous communities and associations because they're part of the national fabric. And so for us, it's important to ensure that their messages get a chance to be presented and that we can work together to make a difference for that community. So that's a little bit of the, I guess, the social side that you were referring to, Warren. Without governments, there is no industry, right? I mean, no projects. And the business community comes here to learn about their very next opportunity. So you're seeing our effort to, in fact, have more and more opportunities to engage with public sector officials, again, both on the podium and through the networking that's taking place. So we started, as I mentioned earlier, with the head of the Inuit community in Canada, the leader of the Inuit community. That's a quasi-government entity, clearly the Premier of Ontario, because Ontario's got the largest investment in infrastructure in Canada, $144 billion, with a significant focus on urban transit, so really important. And the reality is that there have been changes in governments around the country in Canada over the last year. And so we wanted to give those provinces an opportunity to outline the vision and priorities of these new administrations because it's of real interest to the folks in the audience too, right? So the intent is to both showcase the next generation of infrastructure investment while at the same time giving these very same political leaders an opportunity to hear from their own constituents about ways in which they can make adjustments to their programming that will ensure that the bidding community actually bids these projects, right? So it's got these sort of dual objectives to them, and I think that's really important. And we've been very fortunate in that a number of the government leaders that we went after agreed, in fact, to come and speak. And we have a number of public sector officials on panels as well. There's one taking place right now, which has the city manager for Quebec City on the panel. That's great, right? The opportunity to engage the public sector with the private sectors, because that's so much of the reason for why we do what we do, right? It's meant to be that meeting place for government, the private sector, and Indigenous communities, and I think this year we've been very successful in accomplishing that.